Hi, I've really grown to love Costa Rica, and I'm really excited to be sharing it with your kids. So thank you, you guys have loaned them to us, and we want to share some of the projects that we've been doing for the last week and a half.
This is the church. This is our main construction project every year. We were told that 80% of the work on this church, the floors, the pillars, the front, and the classrooms behind it, the two classrooms behind it, have been done by Livingston students since 2009 to 2016. We're very proud of the work we've done here and the partnership we've formed with people here.
Hi, welcome to the church. This is where we did our work project. We had to put sheetrock up there, but how do we get it up there? Let's go check it out.
This is our scaffold. So what we did is we measured how big we need to make the scaffold and how tall to get up to the sheetrock. And then we made it a little schematic and we cut all the pieces out and started putting it together with these lag bolts right here. So it goes through one piece first and then the second piece of bamboo, and we put a bolt on the end to keep it tight. Then we put some rope around in all directions just to keep everything in place. Keep it from moving or bending the pipe. It's actually quite strong, and we didn't even need the rope.
This is our bamboo pile. This is what it looks like. So we went to a bamboo patch about a quarter mile down the road that way, and then I did most of the other cutting. It's not quite like cutting trees at home, I'm afraid. So we cut them. They're about 30 feet or so long. So we cut them all down, had to take them back, carry them on our shoulders or our arms. And the funny part was we had to cross a creek that kind of came into a V form. So it's kind of interesting trying to get through that. So anyway, yeah, it was a lot of fun doing it.
So while everyone else was having fun making bamboo sculptures, we were actually working. We had to mix cement by hand because we had no tools to do it with. And that process started with getting a wheelbarrow full of gravel, putting it here, grabbing some cement, putting it on top, mixing that up, getting some water and pouring that in with a volcano shape. And we had to mix that through until it was thoroughly so Andrew could do his part.
Well, we mixed all the cement that we used right here. But we needed it in the front of the church. So how did we get it here? Well, we shoveled it into a wheelbarrow. Then I had to wheel it all the way up here. You know, that was actually the most difficult part. Wheelbarrow full of cement. It gets pretty heavy. I mean, all upward slope. And then around here. And we dumped the cement in here, and we paved all this.
Hey, so this is up on the iron scaffold. I didn't see it's very sturdy. Oh, three people actually, safely. Maybe even more.
So this right here is our sheetrock. And this protects the church and the multi-purpose room from all the elements, whether it's rain or wind or even sun coming in. And this was our main project, as others have said, and it was very difficult to get these to fit just perfectly, and we used these screws that actually bore their own holes into the metal frame and then they screw into the sheetrock. So we had to cut and measure each one of these boards all the way down, and at the very end it was very difficult because there's nothing you could hold on to. And so Mr. Coke and I had to hold on to each other as we were doing that.
Alright, so when people were on the scaffold, only like two, maybe three people could be up there at a time. So we had a bunch of support crew that would put up the sheetrock, or that would hoist up the sheetrock. And we would also have some people that would pick up screws, which was my main job. Anytime I heard Sequoia, Coke go, Sabrina, I'd know they'd drop a screw or two or three. But so it was really important that we had some people that were there right on the spot, ready just to help in any way they could. We also, whenever the scaffold needed moving, it It took 8-10 of us to move it. So yeah, that's what the support period is.
I was sitting here in the entryway, and before we got here, there was nothing here. These pillars that you see now, they were on the ground here. What we had to do was we had to pick them up with at least like 10 people over here to this slab of concrete, which had the rebar bent towards it, so we could hoist it on there and set it down. And then we filled it with concrete so that it wouldn't move.
So the concrete that I'm actually standing on right now was not here when we first got here. It is what Basto hauled the concrete to work with. And these little walls that have ground in between, we built those as well. And the roof, the church members helped put up. And then to leave our mark, every year the seniors kind of like leave something to remember. We signed that pillar thingy with Sharpie and wrote all of our names. Yeah. Hey guys, so this is called a trapeze. And we made it actually off from scratch. We welded it and we cut all the pieces and we welded it all together and made the cement, everything, all this. We made it, we dug the hole, stuck it in, we painted it. And this is sugar cane and this was made to juice the sugar cane. And we're gonna show you how it works. So we're gonna put that in the middle and then we gotta push it through. And then like that. And there we go. All done. And it's delicious. And straight, you just drink it straight from there. This is called a Mimbro, and it's the first time we had it, the kids gave it to us, and we're going to eat one for you. Ready? One, two, three. They're really, really sour, which I like sour, so I kind of like these. But they don't.
And that? No.